Good afternoon, everybody. I want to thank Chandra and everybody who set this event up today, and everybody for being here, and particularly Lanita and any other folks who are here who have lost loved ones.
Hi, everybody. My name is Lanita Brooks. My son's name is Deshaun Sellers.
And I just wanted to say something about Lanita and Sharita. They have since Deshaun died, which has been seven months, I spoke to them on the phone just a day or two afterwards. They have been at every public meeting, every time we've gone to Dover to try to deal with this problem, they have been there. And every time they come to an event like this or a meeting, they have to relive what happened all over again. And they show up time after time after time, and it has to be agonizing for them, and they do it so that other families don't have to go through what they have gone through.
On February 16, 2015, he walked out my door. 5 minutes later, his friend that he was walking with said he had got shot. Me and my daughter went around there, which is his twin sister, and Deshaun was just laying there. I just want to say to the public, if you see something, speak up, because it was so many people out there that day and nobody said anything. My son laid there on the ground bleeding and nobody spoke up. By the time we got to the hospital, my son was gone. So this year, in April 27th, we celebrated his 18th birthday. They're twins, 18th birthday, and she had to celebrate it alone without her twin brother. I have five other kids, and the ages are, I have an older son, 20 years old, Deshaun's sister, which is 18, I'm sorry. I have a 15-year-old, and then I have a one-year-old little boy that would never see his brother. He won't even know him. So again, if you see anything, speak up. Talk to your kids. If they see anything, speak up. My name is Sharita Sewell. I'm always out supporting my twin. February 16th changed our life forever. Never in a million years would I think that we'd be up here speaking about my nephew who's gone. This speech that we come out here all the time saying, it's like nothing you can prepare for. I wouldn't wish this on my worst enemy. 7 months of pain that I watched my sister go through, 7 months of doubting people, 7 months of watching over her shoulder because we give more information to the cops than what the public who's seen what happened would do. My sister lost 20 pounds after her son died. 20 pounds. She had to go to the doctors just to get her weight back up. This is hard seeing my twin sister walk this journey that she has to walk. When nobody else supports her, but I'm always here. No matter what, no matter how much I get on her nerves, I'm here. She's my older sister, I'm her little sister, and I'm my sister's keeper. We're the voices for the voiceless now. This is what you'll see, because we'll never stop. This is like our promise to Poppy. We're always going to keep his name alive. Always. So this is not the last time you'll see us. This is not the last time you've been seeing us. We've been out here. We've been working. We're trying to encourage more mothers to come out, more people to come out and support us as well.
And we have to make it possible for kids in this state to be able to fulfill their potential. And that means doing things. That means investing in schools, especially high poverty schools, that those kids can come to school and have adults who are there prepared to help them deal with whatever they are dealing with. That means having programs for juveniles after school and during the summertime to help them fulfill their potential. And those things cost money, bottom line. And this is a lean time for the state right now, but just like families do when they're facing lean times, the first thing that they do is they look out for their kids. And that's what we have to do in this state right now, too, and we have to find a way to pay for these things. Today, as we stand here, the state of Delaware has $30 million sitting in a bank account from settlement funds that it's gotten from banks around the country. And we have been saying since January of this year that they should take $9 million of that money right out of the blocks and spend it over the next 3 years investing in high-poverty elementary schools, half of which are right here in the city of Wilmington.
Snitching is not bad. It's saving the next life. It might be saving your life because no one is immune to not being here the next second, the next minute, the next day. Nobody is immune to it. It can happen to me standing here right now. So do we fear every day coming out? Yeah, we do. because we're giving up information that everybody sees and nobody will talk. Yeah, we're scared every single day we walk out of our doors, but we're not stopping. We're not stopping. We're going to keep on moving forward. This is what we're doing.
Just again, want to tell them how grateful I am for what they've done for the city and the state.
It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. So hard to say goodbye to yesterday.